Hello everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is September 3rd, 2022. These days, I am reading this book, Fundamentals of Physics, Halliday and Resnick, 10th edition. I also read this book, Thomas's Calculus, 14th edition. Also, this book, Erwin Krejci, Advanced Engineering Mathematics, 10th edition. Also, this book, Calculus, Metric Version, 9th edition, Early Transcendentals by James Stewart. I also read Advanced Engineering Mathematics, 5th edition, by Dennis G. Gill, Warren S. Wright. Also, Advanced Engineering Mathematics, Peter V. O'Neill, 6th edition. Also, Advanced Engineering Mathematics, Peter V. O'Neill, this is 7th edition. Physics for Scientist and Engineer with Modern Physics, Survey, Juet, this is 9th edition. Why I read so many books simultaneously? Because my IQ is lower than the average IQ of Homo sapiens. Disclaimer: I don't film videos to collect and teach my audience. I don't film videos for commercial reason to make money out of my YouTube videos. I film videos to teach myself. I see myself as an absolute beginner in mathematics, also in physics. I film this video for future Thomas Kim, who may need this video in the future. I try to be kind, not to my audience, but to future me. Thomas Kim in 5 or 10 or even 20 years later, if I still survive at that time. I film videos for my own record. In the book Fundamentals of Physics, Halliday and Resnick, in Chapter 10, Rotation, I would advise you to read this chapter carefully. In this chapter, rotational variables. Understanding rotational variables. Identify that if all parts of a body rotates around a fixed axis locked together. Locked together means the body is a rigid body or solid body. Identify that the angular position of a rotating rigid body is the angle that an internal reference line makes with a fixed external reference line. Apply the relationship between angular displacement and the initial and the final angular position. In a nutshell, in the rotational motion of a rigid body, understanding angular displacement, the initial and the final angular position is the main concern of rotational motion. So, read this chapter very carefully. Kinetic energy of rotation. I will discuss kinetic energy of rotation. Also, torque. I will discuss torque briefly. Then, Newton's second law for rotation. Net torque equals I alpha. I is called moment of inertia. Alpha is called angular acceleration. We will learn this concept. Also, I would recommend to read Physics for Scientist and Engineer. In this book, part 1, you can read rotation of a rigid object about fixed axis, chapter 10. In this chapter 10, you can read more about rotational motion of a rigid body. For example, in chapter 10, section 7, rotational kinetic energy. This book is also very, very useful. But I would highly recommend you to read Thomas's Calculus 14th edition. In this book, chapter 15, application. In this book, chapter 15, section 6, application. This book discusses masses and pulsed moments. Also, table 15.1, mass and pulsed moment formula. Understanding this formula is important, but understanding is one thing. How to use this formula is another. So we have to completely understand the concept of center of mass. Also, what is pulsed moment? If you scroll down, you can find moments of inertia. This part of text explains kinetic energy of a rotating body. So we will understand how to derive this equation, kinetic energy of a rotating body. For rigorous mathematics, I would advise you to read this part of book. I will explain kinetic energy of a rotating body qualitatively. Newton's second law of motion. More specifically, translational motion. F net equals ma. F is net external force acting on body whose mass is m experiences acceleration. Acceleration is vector quantity. M, the mass of the body, is scalar quantity. F is vector quantity. Net external force acting on the body whose mass is M. Torque is defined R cross F. I would say net torque equals R cross F. R is a position vector of the point of the application of the external force or forces F. More correctly, it should be summation like this. But for the sake of simplicity of our discussion, I will express like this. We can say F net. We substitute this equation for F net. Then it becomes R cross M A. A is vector quantity, can be splitted A tangential component plus A radial component. Then it becomes R cross M A tangential component plus m a radial component. If we distribute m a t plus r cross m a r m a r, here this AR, this AR is radial acceleration. By radial, I mean AR and R are parallel. Parallel means this component is zero. So torque equals R cross M A T tangential component. We can say R, the length of this vector, sweeps angle theta. This distance is L. Y is S. We differentiate dt ds. This equation, we assume R is constant. Then R dt d theta. Theta is angular position. Here dt ds. B, tangential velocity. Dt d theta is omega or angular velocity. So vt equals r omega. We have to memorize this relation. Now we differentiate this expression once again. Dt dvt equals dt square d square s equals r dt square d square theta or r dt d omega or r alpha. Alpha is dt square d square theta or dt d omega. This alpha is called angular acceleration. To this equation, this quantity is AT. So we can say AT equals R alpha. R alpha. We substitute R alpha for AT. AT. Then T equals R cross M R alpha. Alpha is vector quantity. Or we can say this is vector quantity. We can say M R R R square alpha. With T, the magnitude of torque. From this equation, we can say torque equals M R square alpha, angular acceleration, or like this. Then I alpha is talk, where I is scalar quantity defined MR square. We can compare F equals MA. We call I moment of inertia. Moment of inertia. We have to memorize this relation. This equation torque equals I alpha is called Newton's second law of rotation. Please compare this equation with F equals MA. This equation I is defined MR square or sigma MI RI square or R square DM and is called moment of inertia. Now, let's move on. Kinetic energy is defined 1 over 2 mv square, where v is translational velocity. In this case, this is a scalar quantity, so translational speed can be more correct term. So Vt, if you remember, is r omega, angular velocity. We substitute r omega to this equation. Then we can say kinetic energy 1 over 2 m r omega square equals 1 over 2 m r square omega square. Then 1 over 2 m r square omega square. We defined moment of inertia m r square. So it becomes 1 over 2 I omega square. This is kinetic energy over rotating body. Kinetic energy over rigid rotating body. For more rigorous discussion about rotational motion of a rigid body, please refer to Fundamentals of Physics, Halliday and Lesnik. Also, Thomas's Calculus, 14th edition. Also, Physics for Scientists and Engineers with Modern Physics by Sergey Chebet. Also, James Stewart, Calculus, Early Transcendentals. I don't have PDF for 9th edition. This is 8th edition. In this episode, we will solve one or two problems from this book, Fundamentals of Physics, Halliday and Lesnik. From chapter 10, you can find problems. If you scroll down, you can solve all the problems, but I will solve one or two problems in my current episode. The simplest one, this one. Problem 95. The rigid body shown In figure 1057, figure 1057, problem 95, consists of three particles connected by metalless rod, M one body, 2M two body, 2M three body. This forms
an isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle, an isosceles triangle.
An isosceles triangle, because this side length B, this side length B, a triangle with two sides of same length is called
an isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle.
An isosceles triangle. It is to be rotated about an axis perpendicular to its plane through point P. So this point P is the axis of rotation. If M is 0.4 kilogram, A is 30 centimeters, B, 50 centimeters. Please note the unit. The unit is centimeters. We have to convert centimeters into meter unit. Once again, we have to convert centimeters or centimeters into meter unit. How much work is required to take the body from rest to an angular speed 5 radians per second? So the body is initially at rest. We want to give or exert energy to this system of particles to make them rotate about P, the axis of rotation. We want to make this system rotate with angular speed 5.0 radian per second. We will solve this problem first because it looks very simple. Now is the time to bring out your favorite calculator. I decided to film this video to brag about my new calculator. This is my new calculator. Very sexy. Apex 9860G3. I invested on this calculator as much as USD 200, or so much. But when my ship comes home, I will buy a new calculator. This one, TI Inspire CX2T CAS. When my ship comes home, I would purchase this calculator too. Do I have a ship? No. My ship went out or lost. I am not talking about a ship that looks like this with fancy sails, but I am talking about ship that looks like this. It went out of my home and is lost. When it comes home, I will also buy this sexy looking calculator. But for this episode, I will fire up Mathematica and arrange side by side like this. We will be using kinetic energy equation 1 over 2 or half times I omega square, because our system is initially at rest. If it is to rotate with the angular speed 5.0 radian per second, we have to give energy kinetic energy of this amount. We have to give enough energy to make our system of particles rotate with angular velocity omega 5.0 radian per second. We need to calculate I, angular momentum. We cannot use symbol I because this symbol is defined in the Mathematica. So we use MI. We make it a function RM. M times R times R. So we defined MI wa moment of inertia. Now we need to compute distance from P to M. I will let it H 2. We are using Pythagorean theorem. So B square. B is defined like this. 50.0 over 100. We have to define like this. This is B square minus A square. A is 30 centimeter. 30.0 over 100. We have to convert to meter unit. Square. Enter. So from M to P, distance square is H. Computed like this. Now M we call this function. The distance A 30 over 100. This is A. Then its mass 2.0 times 040 kilogram plus we copy this paste. I will close it for the time being. This is A the same this part then faced. I will make it square root then H. Enter. I will delete this part. Now H distance from P to M. Our weight M is this. Hit enter. Let's recalculate. Evaluation. Evaluate. Notable. Sorry, I made stupid mistake. Recalculate. Notable. Okay, it worked. This M is for I, or moment of inertia. I will delete this. Then kinetic energy 1 over 2 times m times omega square. This is our omega square. Hit enter. So its unit is joule. Joule. Now double check the answer. So chapter 10 rotation problem. Scroll down. Answers to checkpoints. Chapter 10 problem 95. We will make it bigger. 2.6 joule. 2.6 joule. We solved this problem correctly. This application just crashed. So, chapter 10 problem 95. Don't forget unit conversion for distance A and B. We should use meter unit. We will solve another problem. We can delete by clicking this. Then delete. I will label like this. Fundamentals of Physics. Page 319. Chapter 10. Problem. We can re-evaluate the notebook like this. Go to File. Save. We will create a new folder. 049 kinetic energy. In this folder, problem 95. Save. We will create a new notebook and close this one. Now we will solve more advanced one. Scroll up. You can find chapter 10 rotation problem 43. Problem 43. I will make it bigger. Save. Problem 43. This is more advanced. We are going to solve this problem. Before we solve this problem, we will use Thomas's Calculus 14th edition from chapter 15. Application. If you scroll down, you can find chapter 15.6 application, masses and pulsed movements. It explains how to calculate moments of inertia. This is a very good sample. I will solve it. Thomas's Calculus, page 921, example 3. And if you scroll down, you can find exercise 15.6, problem 21. We will solve this problem first. So we are solving this problem, moments of inertia. Shift enter. find the moments of inertia of angular solid shown here with respect to its edges by calculating Ix, Iy, Iz. So we are calculating Ix, Iy, Iz with respect to this edge. This edge. This edge. We will start with this edge first. So I see rotational moment of inertia with respect to Z axis. We open up palette. We have this fancy palette. You can find advanced. We need integration here. Select this integration. Select this cell. Integration. Select this cell. Integration. So here we need x square plus y square. This is distance from a point on this block. For example, here, look at the mouse cursor point. Our x is here. From this point, we need distance to Z axis. If our point on this block is at this point, at the end of mouse cursor, then the distance square is x square plus y square. This is distance. This is r square. We need density. Our density, I will use type setting. This symbol, this is Greek alphabet delta. So I inserted delta here. Delta is density times volume. Volume can be dz, dy, dx. Lower, upper, z. So lower end is zero. Up end is C. Lower end is zero. Up end is C. Now dy. Y. Lower end is zero. Zero. Up end is B. B. Dz. Lower end is zero. So zero. Up end is A. So A. Now here, shift enter. This is our calculation. Please note that A times B times C is volume. A times B times C is volume. A times B times C is volume times density. So this is mass. A times B times C delta times this is M mass of the block. Okay, now shift enter. We can copy this. Copy, paste. Now, X. We want to rotate this block with respect to X axis. Then it rotates about the X axis. So this is the same, but the distance, if the point on this block is here, look at the mouse point, then the distance from this point X to X axis is Y square, just square. Hit enter. So this is moment of inertia with respect to X axis. Now copy this. This is now Y. Now X. Hit enter. So we have this result. I mean IX equals M over 3 B square plus C square. In the same manner, IY equals A square C square. IZ is A square B square. Don't forget this. Now go up, go up. We can try this example. This is exactly the same, but we are rotating our block with respect to center of block, the origin of the rotational axis lies at the center of this block. So the range of the integration is different. For example, I will copy this and paste. This is now here. We can use this fancy fraction 2/A. This is negative. Copy, paste. This is positive. Copy this, paste it here. This is B. Paste it here. This is negative B. Paste it here. This is negative C. Paste it here. This is positive C. I will name it ICOM. Jet. COM stands for center of mass. Okay? Now hit shift enter. So A times B times C times delta. This is volume. So we can say 1/12 or m/12 times A square plus B square. In this case, when we rotate this block about the center of this block or center of mass about Z axis, our computational result m/12 A square plus B square. When we rotate our block with respect to Z axis, then this is m/3. The factor is different. The rest are the same. So this is IZ. This is I center of mass jet. We have to compare this equation with this equation. Now, shift enter. We can solve this problem now. I will close it. Begin Fundamentals of Physics, problem 43. We can use this formula. We are using these formulas. I x, our mass, 0.172 over 3.0 times. We are computing this part. B, this is centimeter. So 8.4 over 100 square plus, now C square, 1.4 centimeter, 1.4 centimeter. We have to convert into meter. Our density, we don't need density, and is uniform. Uniform means density is constant. Now shift enter. In the same manner, copy paste. Here, this is IY. We are computing this part. A is 3.5. A is 3.5. Then C. C is 1.4. This. Then hit enter. Now copy this. I Z. We are computing this part. A is 3.5. B is 8.4. Now shift enter. So I will delete this part. Well, we can say evaluate notable. We evaluated again. This is chapter 10, problem 43. Scroll down. Answer. Chapter 10, problem 43. Make it bigger. 4.7 times 10 to the negative 4 kilogram meter square. So this one, IZ, this is the answer. Let's double check our problem. This is the problem. This answer is correct.